Ooh, take a look at this woman. She wants to go shopping at this store. She wants to go to this store and buy some stuff. But when she gets close to the store, she sees that the owner is closing the store. The owner is locking up the store. So she thinks, oh no, I'll have to come back tomorrow. So what should she ask this woman? What should she ask her? Do you know? Well, in this lesson, I'm going to teach you what to say. Hey, if you like getting tips like this, I'd be so happy if you subscribe to my channel right down there. Okay, she should say, what time do you open tomorrow? What time do you open tomorrow? Okay, then that woman might say, we open at 7 o'clock, or we open at 7 a.m. 7 a.m. Or she might just say, we open at 7. 7. Okay, I mean, it's common sense that it will be in the morning, right? A store doesn't open at 7 p.m. That would be crazy, right? So, you know, she might say we open at 7 o'clock. She might say we open at 7 a.m. Or she might say we open at 7. Okay, that's how we say the time in English. You have three options, okay? Now, you might want to ask this question. Are you open on weekends? Are you open on weekends? You know, some businesses are closed on weekends, right? But you know what? If this is a normal store here in Canada, it's probably open on the weekends at least for one day, probably at least for Saturday. Okay, so she might say, we're open on Saturdays from 10 to 5, but we're closed on Sundays. Okay? We're open on Saturdays from 10 to 5, but we're closed on Sundays. Okay? Now, let's say you're inside a store and you want to know what time the store will close. Okay? Then you could say this, excuse me, what time do you close? Okay? Let's say that person works at the store. Excuse me, what time do you close? Excuse me, what time do you guys close? Sometimes we use the word guys. What time do you guys close? Like, if I were asking this, I would probably say guys. It depends. If that person is young, I might say, excuse me, what time do you guys close? If she is, like, a bit older, like, if she's, I don't know, if she's, like, you know, maybe my mom's age or my grandma's age, I might say, excuse me, what time do you close? I might still say guys. I don't know. Sometimes I say guys, sometimes I don't say guys. I'll have to think about that, okay? So you can choose. You could say, excuse me, what time do you close? Or what time do you guys close? Even though it's sometimes people think the word guys is only talking about men, only men. But it's not, right? Very often people use guys for even a group of girls. Hey, do you guys want to go for some coffee? Do you guys want to go for ice cream, right? Maybe there are no men in the group, but we still use the word guys. So even though, like, technically the word guy means man, guys is also used for women. Women use it with each other. A woman will say to some other women, hey, do you guys want to, you know, so it's very common. The word guys is like it's a casual, you know, just, yeah, it's a very casual word to use in different situations. Okay, now look at this. What time do you close? What time are you closing? Both of these mean the same thing. So don't get confused. Sometimes we use, you know, this verb tense. Sometimes we use this verb tense. Okay. What time do you close? What time are you closing? They mean the same thing. Okay. Or like this. What time do you open tomorrow? What time are you opening tomorrow? What time are you opening tomorrow? What time are you guys opening tomorrow? Okay. They mean the same thing. So don't worry about it. You can choose whichever one you want to use, okay? We close at 5. We're closing at 5. the same thing, right? They mean exactly the same thing. Or like this, we open at 8, we're opening at 8. We're opening at 8, okay? So again, you know, it's your choice. You can choose whatever you want, okay? Now, you might want to ask, are you open on Boxing Day? Are you open on Boxing Day? Boxing Day is December 26th, the day after Christmas. Usually stores have a lot of sales on Boxing Day. Boxing Day blowout sales, maybe 50% off something. If you want to buy a new TV or a new computer, you might want to look for some Boxing Day sales to get a good deal, okay? Are you open on? That's saying, will you be open, okay? Or are you going to be open? All of these mean the same thing. Now, you might use these, right? You might be used to using these. Will you be open or are you going to be open? Because these are future tense, right? We're talking about the future, right? Boxing Day is in the future. That's very clear in this sentence. So you might think it's right to use the word will or going to, but actually, sometimes we use the simple present tense in English to talk about the future as well. Okay, look, are you open? That is the simple present verb tense, right? Are you open? That means right now, right? Usually, are you open? That's talking about the present. But when we add a future time reference onto that, then it becomes future. Okay, so very often we talk like this in English. We use the simple present verb tense to talk about the future. Now, I explained all this stuff in my series on verb tenses. So if you haven't seen my series on verb tenses, the link is down there in the description of this video. You can watch all my lessons on verb tenses, okay? So you could use this, you know, not for Boxing Day or for any day, right? For maybe Thanksgiving, you could say, are you open on Thanksgiving? Are you open on Christmas Day? Are you open on Easter? Okay. Or if you want to ask about a range of dates, you know, you could say this, are you open over the holidays? Are you open over the holidays? Now, usually the holidays means the Christmas holidays, right? Every year in Canada here, at least, and in the US, okay, there's a period of time called the Christmas holidays. There are other holidays in the year, like Easter holidays, but it's not as big. Christmas holidays is more of like a period of time. Usually, you know, it might go from December 20th to January 5th. Okay, so this range of dates, that is sort of called the Christmas holidays or just the holidays. Okay, so are you open over the holidays? Now, someone recently asked me in the comments, they said, this word here, over, can I also say during? Are you open during the holidays, right? Over and during. Yes, you can say that. They mean exactly the same thing, except I think this is more common, okay? Are you open over the holidays? When we're talking about like the holidays, when we're talking about, you know, a period of days, then we use over. Are you open over those days? Are you open over the holidays? I think this one is more common, but you can say this as well. It's your choice, okay? So I want to know, do you usually work over the holidays or do you get time off? Maybe your company gives you like a week or 2 weeks off over the holidays, but maybe you have to work. So let me know down there, do you usually have to work over the holidays? I'll see you over in the next episode of Mad English TV. Take care.